3 minute education sessions. What can I talk about? I've been asked to talk to you about table topics, how to master table topics, how to do well at table topics, so on and so forth. You guys would have probably heard about methods that you can use to come up with a story. You would have, how many of you have heard of the probe method? It's an orators club thing. Okay, only two people. Pramoda, yes. Probe method, okay. Probe, and how many of you have heard of A to C? One person. Okay, so probe and A to C, I will come to later if I have time. But the main thing that you want to do when you want to master table topics is to get rid of the fear of speaking. That's all it is. See, table topics in Toastmasters is the most scary thing because now you're coming here unprepared. With the prepared speech, the fear is sort of put away because you're like, okay, I know what I have to do. But table topics, there's an added element of I don't know what to do. So how do you master that fear? How do you get rid of that fear? How do you become hard-nosed? Okay. Someone who is practical, determined, and tough-minded. You have to realize that other people's opinions don't matter. Repeat after me. Other people's opinions don't matter. You said it with so much confidence and gusto, guys. One more time.
Other people's opinions don't matter.
One more time.
Other people's opinions don't matter. Other people's opinions don't matter.
What does that mean?
Other people's opinions don't matter.
Wow. Guys, when I speak on stage, I want to do dumb, stupid things because it's fun for me. I wanted to slap the board, that's why I wrote hard-nosed here. Because if I slap this, it'll break. Right? That's all. I just wanted to do that stupid thing, so I wrote it on the board. Why do I want to do dumb, stupid things? Because it's fun. And if it's not fun for me, I will not perform well. Right? But obviously, doing things like that can be embarrassing. We don't try them. But you have to remember that ultimately, if you give a poor performance or if you do something stupid on stage, nobody will care for more than 5 minutes. Nobody will care. Especially not in Toastmasters will anybody care about what you did. We've had speakers come on stage, fluster for 30 seconds and then go back and sit down because they couldn't speak. This is for prepared speeches. People who came prepared said, I'm sorry, I can't do it, and gone and sat down. Nobody cared. At the end of the session, everybody was telling them, it's okay, we want you to come back the next time. Right? So when you don't define the fears you have in your head, this is not just true of speaking, but of anything. If you don't define the fear, it's an empty void. And when it's an empty void, it looks big and therefore it looks like something that cannot be conquered. So what is the worst thing that can happen to you when you speak on stage during a table topic? Two things. You can get a heart attack, obviously. That's the worst thing that can happen, right? What will happen if you have a heart attack? Will everybody here just let you die? No. We have emergency medical services in this building. The ambulance will be called. Somebody maybe will know CPR, will be taken care of. So you're not going to die. You're laughing. I'll take 1 moment. You're laughing, but that's serious. Define the fear. What will happen? What's the other bad thing that can happen? Not a heart attack. Everybody will judge you and everybody will hate you and nobody will want to be your friend. That's not true in Toastmasters. You've seen it, right? So guys, just remember, define the fear. Realize that other people's negative opinions don't matter because ultimately, meaning is not part of what is happening. Meaning is something that you give it. Somebody can give you critical feedback, but if you don't believe that they are correct, if you don't believe that they know what they're talking about, you will not take it. You will not be put down by that negative criticism. That's why I say other people's opinions don't matter. The meaning that you give to something is ultimately the meaning that is there in it. And that's how you conquer table topics. That's all I had. 3 minutes are up. You can clap now so that I can get upstairs.